Tommy, in a market dominated by Samsung and Apple, a new player is now entering the market. And this morning we can reveal all the devices being launched. And it's an Aussie company. They are called Mint. And with those plus a huge range of smartphones for you to consider, our tech expert Trevor Long has come in this morning. Very good morning to you, Trevor. So, firstly, Aussie player getting into the market up against the big guns. They're called Mint. Who are they? And are they any good?
A young Aussie entrepreneur a few years ago created this company, but didn't launch them here, launched them in places like Papua New Guinea and Timor-Leste, just basically took on other parts of the world, which I think is cool because it means these are not the first phones they've made. These are not the first phones they've brought to market. They've got a bit of experience, they've tested their products, they know what they're in for. So they've essentially gone, well, hang on, that's working for us. Let's create a whole new range. So these are all, this is a whole new range that will work for the Australian market, and they're launching next week here.
All right, they've got four phones under $400. So what sort of competition are we talking about in this range of the market?
Oh, this is a packed space. So there's 14 phones here. I've gone a little bit crazy. Yeah. Every single one of these phones is under $400, right? So if we look here, these are all under $200, okay? Now, this is a great starting point, the Alcatel 1X. It's $179. It's a great little phone, nice and easy to hold, you know, great little camera, but you know, not really the top-end phone. You've got to remember, these are lacking in something somewhere along the way. Every phone is. And this is the Mint here. There's a couple of Mints under $200. So you're talking $179, $199 for the different Mint options. The thing Mint have done here is they've gone dual lens camera, fingerprint sensor, facial recognition. They've pretty much packed all of those buzzword technologies into every single one of their phones. So not a bad start in terms of price points for them.
If you step up a little bit to the next level, what can you get in this level? And these prices obviously are all just for the phone unit themselves.
That's right. And so these phones, for example, like the LG and the Nokia here, these have been out for a few years. Mm-hmm. But these are the prices I found them at retail stores in Australia up against the launch prices for the Mint. So the Mint here is $235. Now, the camera's going to be slightly better, the performance is going to be better, the screen's going to be better. These are the things that start to go up a level as you start to go up the price point. But again, you know, this is a 4G capable phone, 3,000 milliamp hour battery, which means you're going to get all day performance, and you're only spending just a couple of dollars over $200. So outright price, and these are the phones that people are not buying on contracts. You're buying these phones outright and you're owning them for the whole life. And here's the thing I noticed too, just in the retail, I opened these last night. They come with a little case and a screen protector as well. You know, spending $200 and you're getting a little plastic case and a screen protector. I like that because most people are going to struggle, if it's not an Apple or a Samsung, you're going to struggle to find those cases at retail stores.
Okay, so these sort of phones around these prices, I guess that would be great if you're looking at buying a phone for the kids, perhaps?
Spot on. This to me is the price point for kids, especially first phones. Yep. My son Jackson, for example, this is the Alcatel 3. It's $279. He's 12, he's in high school. He used this phone for a week, won't give it back to me because it's fine. It's great. It does everything he needs to do. Now, to be clear, he didn't come from a $2,000 phone to that. He had a couple hundred dollar phone and got to try this one. Great camera, great screen, looks good, it's lightweight. I mean, these are all quite beautiful as well. They're, you know, they've got a nice colour to them. They're shiny blue, they're different colours, they're metallic silver. They put a lot into the design. So that's the Mint version there at about $265. So again, under $300, I think this is a great price point for kids, first phones, high school.
OK, so being a dad myself with young kids, this is kind of going off the grid a little bit, but what age would you recommend buying a phone for a kid?
Everyone's different, but in our household, we went high school. You know, once you get into high school, you're travelling more, you're probably catching the bus there, you might be walking home. You've also got a little bit of independence after school, you might be going to the shops. That's when, as a parent, it's really about when you as a parent want your kid to be contactable and have a little bit of independence. So that's when we went, high school's the tipping point. It also makes it easy for the other kids, because then you remember it was high school. You don't have to debate about what age it was. So, you know, you don't have to, but critically, don't spend $1,000 on your kid's first phone, because they're going to break it, they're going to lose it, and these things are much easier to replace when it's only a few hundred dollars.
Yeah, all right. Now, stepping up to one level above, what have you got here for us?
So this is the close to $400 range, between $300 and $400. Now, the Mint in this bunch is $399. Now, I use this for a week. It's a beautiful phone. It has a triple lens camera on the back, and that's what you're getting in a $2,000 phone. The Huawei's, the Samsung's of the world, $2,000 phones have triple lens cameras, fingerprint sensor, facial recognition, beautiful screen, great performance. So that's a pretty cracking product, and that's why I think you'll find Mint's tagline is going to be something to do with, you know, most affordable based on specs. So here, they don't look like the most affordable. When you put them side by side with other products, it's pretty epic what they've done. Samsung have a great phone here at the A30. This is, you know, a beautiful screen. It's probably the best screen here under $200. A good pick, though, is the Huawei. Huawei make a great phone. This is high-performance, beautiful camera. And this is where, you know, for $400, honestly, this is not kids. This is everything anyone at any price point, any age, needs in a smartphone.
So what are you not getting in these that you're getting in a $2,000 phone?
The only difference is the cameras go up another level, the screens go up another level, the resolution of the screens. But honestly, in I use this phone here for like 3 months. Mm-hmm. You don't notice it in day-to-day use. It's only when you take it to a holiday and you're taking snaps and you're comparing it with your partner who's got a $2,000 phone. But those snaps, I don't want to break it to you, they're going on Facebook and Instagram. They're not going to look any different to anyone. So yep. $400 for a brand new Aussie phone on the market and a bunch of other options around it, this is a really great category and a great price point for everyone to look at.
All right, terrific, Trev. There's some great advice there. Good to see an Aussie company in the market fighting the big guys as well. Georgie?
Indeed.